B-Monster Laboratory here. Today we're going to connect a photocell or photoresistor to our Elegoo Mega 2560 microcontroller. We're going to see how we can measure light intensity using an analog input. Now originally I was just going to skip over the photocell. It's a photoresistor, right? Kind of boring. As it turns out, my kids really enjoy this project. They like seeing how the LEDs respond to the amount of light that shines on top of the photocell. Now, I love any project with LEDs, and they were right, it is pretty neat. So I thought I'd share that with you today. Now, the photocell has many useful applications, such as in alarms and robots, such as line following robots. If you can think of any more, list them in the comments below, and let's begin.
In this video, we're using an Elegoo Mega 2560 microcontroller, a breadboard, 8 LEDs. You'll also need 8 220 ohm resistors. You'll also need a 1000 ohm resistor. I'm also using a 74HC595 shift register. You need a photoresistor and 16 male-to-male jumper wires.
As you can see right here, I'm using the A0 as an analog input, and it's connected right in between this photocell or photoresistor and the 1000 ohm resistor. If this circuit does look familiar, it's because I used the same setup in the 595 shift register video that I did. Now, if you missed the video on that and you want to know how to connect the 595 shift register, I will include a link in the description below and in the video. Now, the photocell is used as a type of light dependent resistor, and in many ways it acts just like this resistor right here, this 1000 ohm resistor, except the resistance changes in response to how much light is falling on it. Now, this photocell has a resistance of about 50,000 kiloohms in near darkness and about 500 ohms in bright light. In order to convert the value of resistance into something measurable on this microcontroller, we're going to go ahead and use the analog input. Now, in order to measure the changing value of resistance on this microcontroller's analog input, it needs to be converted into a voltage. And the easiest way to do that is to combine it with a fixed resistor. Now, the resistor and the photocell together behave like a potentiometer. And when the light's very bright, the resistance in the photocell is very low compared to the fixed value resistor. And so it's as if the potentiometer were turned all the way up. And when the photocell's in dull light, the resistance becomes greater than the 1000 ohm resistor we're using. And it's as if the potentiometer was turned all the way down. Now, if we load up the lesson 26 sketch, we can see just how the photocell reacts when your finger is over top of it and when it's exposed to light. Now, I'm going to go ahead and include a schematic here just in case you're interested. So this is our code, and up here we define the analog pin as our light pin. We also define pin 11, 9, and 12 as the latch pin, the clock pin, and the data pin of our 595 shift register. And down here we create an integer called LEDs, and that is initially set at 0. We come down here to the setup, and we see that the latch pin, the data pin, and the clock pin are defined as outputs. Come down here to update shift register. This is going to set the latch pin low, then call Arduino function shift out before setting the latch pin high again. And the shift out function has four parameters. The first two are the data pin and the clock pin. Your third parameter is the least significant bit first. This is the bit order in which the data is received. It's essentially which LED will light up first. You can do least significant or most significant bit first. And the fourth parameter is the actual data to be shifted into the shift register. And for us, that's going to be LEDs. Then we come down here to the loop, and we see that the code calls for reading the light pin. The light pin is analog pin 0, and it's going to take that raw data and divide it by 57 and break that into 9 different segments. Those segments will be no LEDs lit all the way to 8 LEDs being lit. And then down here we'll see that each LED will be lit in sequence, one at a time. And then down here we have the update shift register, and then it does it all over again. Now, if you want to see the raw data on your serial monitor with this circuit, you can go up here and initialize your serial communication with the correct baud speed. Now, if we scroll down here, you can see that we're using the serial monitor to read some analog values and give us some quantitative data using some parameters including dark, dim, light, bright, and very bright. So you can include this code right here at the end of your loop, and it will give you that data in your serial monitor. And we'll go up here and open up our serial monitor under Tools, Serial Monitor, and you can see those values change as I'm covering and uncovering the photocell. That's all I've got for today. As always, thank you very much for watching, and I'll see you again very soon with another video.